Frank Dumas is back from the St. George Eco Mining, and today we are going to speak about a subsidiary of St. George's called H2SX. Now, H2SX is all about renewable energy, specifically green carbon. Frank, please introduce us.
Well, H2SX is a company that we formed or created in 2021, and this is the consequence of a pre-feasibility study we were doing for the battery processing side of the business and the lithium recovery or lithium refining side of the business. We were talking to potential partners on the lithium side, and everybody was looking and saying, okay, if you're at a fraction of the OPEX and a fraction of the CAPEX, of the lowest CAPEX, lowest OPEX and CAPEX producer in China, what's going to stop them from putting you in a corner and making it very difficult for you to go in production, since they control the spodumene market or spodumene price that they were kind of manipulating back then? And we saw that when they brought it up and then collapse it, and affect a lot of spodumene producer, including a lot of Australian spodumene producer, that changed their business plan in terms of transformation. And then they kicked out a lot of people out of the production or refining business, as they thought that spodumene price will remain high and that there was more money to be made there. Now, the price got cut many times. It drops to a very low level. It's coming back up now. It's up 100% from the low. But we had these questions from institutions and from the Canadian government while they were reviewing the projects and they were testing and vetting the technology. He said, well, are you going to acquire your nitric acid, which is the acid we use to do the leaching? And how do you you process, how do you manufacture nitric acid? So we spoke with some of the biggest producer of nitric acid in North America and asked them, if we increase the amount of nitric acid we order from you, because at this stage we're ordering very small quantity for lab experiment and like smaller batch pilot experiment. And they said, well, you're going to fallen between chair because you're going to be too small for us to increase production, and you're going to be too big. We're going to have to ask other buyers to delay orders and things like that. So we're going to need to have some guarantee. And we realize, okay, that's the one of the weak point of this tech. If we're to go into production, we need to secure a way to produce nitric acid. And there's a cost also, logistical and transport. So logistic and transport is part of the cost of bringing that nitric acid. It's one of the biggest costs that we have to this technology. And we realized, okay, hydrogen would allow us, if we have a hydrogen production, would allow us to have our own nitric acid on site and not having to transport it and pay these costs. And it's probably cheaper to do hydrogen if we use SMR, so steam reform hydrogen. What's interesting is we had a PhD on our on the team that were doing the pre-feasibility. So the independent consultant that was doing the pre-feasibility was a specialist of hydrogen, he's a physicist. And he said, I've been collaborating with a group of Korean companies and governmental entity like the National Center for Cold Fusion in Korea, and some of the big players, Samsung and the KB Bank, and a few other names that I'm forgetting now, but all linked to either one of the large conglomerate or the government directly. And we've developed a technology that is converting natural gas or methane and biogas into hydrogen with no carbon emission. So what comes out of it is solid carbon, so graphene and carbon black, and pure hydrogen. So you can just connect yourself to a pipe or a pipeline of natural gas and produce your own hydrogen. Now that's interesting because hydrogen is something that I've been following for years as a, you know, just an interested person, like I'm a bit of a nerd on these things. And so I was keeping track of where they were going, and yet all these electrolysis projects that most of them were never going to be economical without big government help, big subsidies on the cost of electricity, and then probably subsidies again on transportation. Because the biggest drawback of the hydrogen sector is how do you transport hydrogen? You don't have the infrastructure that oil and gas has in place. You don't have these pipelines. And even if you had them, if you talk to specialists, they'll tell you that's a complex challenge. And so we realize a lot of the end user, so the steel mill, the big industrial plant that would love to use hydrogen because they would decarbonate that way, they're using natural gas right now often. So we could go into their parking lot, put one of these modules there, tap into their pipeline of natural gas, and we can produce the carbon that they need for the steel mill, and we can produce the hydrogen they're going to use. And that becomes interesting because suddenly they totally decarbonate that part of their operation.
Frank, I understand that H2SX is a subsidiary of St. George Eco Mining, but you also have co-owners, is that right?
So H2SX is owned by, majority owned by St. George. So we own 80%, give or take, of the company. Korean partners that own the IP own 10% of it. And there's a company run by Sabin Boli, which is the PhD that joined us, who's also the present CEO of H2SX, who owns the balance, and is developing also some additional IP for this company. The goal with H2SX, and we receive offer in the past from some green funds, and they've kind of walked back a bit on their side because of lack of financing from their side, not from the vetting of the technology. They're still very interested, but we've decided recently that we're going to move forward and find new buyers or spin off this company and have it into a new public entity. It's not bringing any valuation to the capitalization of St. George. It's kind of hidden between the other subsidiary, and it's not our core business. It's something that we need in the future, probably, to secure the access to nitric acid, but we can have that with an agreement with them, even if they go on their own and they're totally independent. And at this stage, if you look at where they are, they have since last year a pilot plant that was built back in Seoul. And that's, we can bring people there and show them the technology. They can touch the carbon. They can see the results. We've been able to prove that this is now more economical or less energy intensive than SMR. And the competition is really SMR. So if you look at any way that hydrogen is produced in the world right now, 98% of it, give or take, is done by SMR. The rest is all these alternative technology like electrolysis and things like that. So we're coming in, and our real competitor is SMR. And that we want to go in and basically just replace what SMR is with this tech and be less expensive to operate. And you have an OPEX that's less expensive than SMR. And that's the only way I think this thing would work. And that's the next stage. So there's discussion with different companies right now that are on the downstream of it. So people that want to do fertilizer, ammonium or ammoniac production, people that want to do methanol, and they all need or would be able to use this technology. And that's the next development. And we realize, okay, so we could put a lot of press release about this, but it's not going to move the needle for us. But if it's on its own, it will. So that's the next stage. And we're open to suggestion, but we're having discussion right now to probably list this entity. And that's an interesting part here on the Canadian market and most probably on the Australian market also, because there's a kind of an affinity with a few players in Australia. Right?
So in the meantime, while you are looking at ways to spin H2SX out, can you tell me what will be the next steps for the technology itself? And what's the sort of timeline we're looking at to bringing it to market?
The next step is the commercial operation. So one megawatt modules that can be upgraded to 4 megawatts, that the core cost of it is about $15 million Canadian. And that's something that can be, the money can be recouped, the investment can be recouped within 2 years from the numbers that we have right now. I'm going to say big caveat here, we don't have a feasibility study. So these are internal numbers. We think it's going to be in that range. It could be a year more, a year less, depending on where, depending on which partner we have, and what are the actual costs, because there's partner that are around the company that might come in with infrastructure in place already, with building, access to natural gas, and probably also manpower and scientific manpower. So depending on how the final agreement or final form and deal would be in place, this is something that would be probably proving its commercial viability within the next 5 years easily, and become disruptive players in the market.
Frank, it's been fascinating to learn all about green carbon and this subsidiary of St. George Eco Mining, H2SX.